In the previous tutorial, we have learned how to create this object. Now, in this tutorial, we will learn to create this slab, then railings, then these rooms, and this roof. If up till now you have not subscribed to this channel, then please subscribe to this channel and press the bell icon. Please also like and share this video. Let's start with this tutorial. So at first we will create these rooms. So we will be creating these rooms using existing data. So what we will do, at first we will copy these rooms and then we will edit to create our desired rooms. So for copy, click here on copy. Then for easy selection, just orbit it and use crossing window and select it. So it will select all the rooms. Then press enter, specify base point here, take your cursor outside. Ensure that your ortho mode is on and click, press escape and orbit it. So here these rooms has been copied. Then we want to keep these two rooms and remove all these other rooms. So to remove these rooms, we will have to slice it. For slice, click here on slice. Then select this object, press enter. Now we want to slice it with respect to this face. So actually this face is parallel to ZX plane. So for that, click here on ZX. Then you will have to specify a point on ZX plane. So that point will be the same point. So click there. Then click here on keep both sides. And here you will see that it has been sliced. So what we will do, we will move this portion away. So for that, again we will orbit it in this way so that it will be easy to select. Then click here on move. Then select this object, press enter, specify this point, take it away and click. So here this portion is separated. Now in this portion again, we want to separate this room also. So again we will slice with respect to this face, that is ZY plane. So again click here on slice, then select this object, press enter, then click here on YZ plane, then specify point here, then you can also right click and click here on keep both sides. So here you will see that this and this portion has been separated. So we don't want this portion, but we want this reference point. So to keep location of this point, type PO for point, press enter and click here on this endpoint, because we want to maintain this total width same. Then remove this portion, for that type E, enter and select this portion. Press enter, again E, enter, select these rods, enter. So here is the point. If point is not visible properly, you can also use DDP type, press enter and change point style. Okay, so here point is properly visible. Then we will create room on this side by mirroring this room. So for mirror, click here on 3D mirror. Then select this object, enter, then I will mirror it around this point. So I want to mirror it around this face, that means I will have to use this ZY plane. So click here on YZ, then specify point on YZ plane, so I will click here. So to catch this point, shift plus right click and click here on node and click here on this point. Then delete source object, no. So here mirror is created. Then we will move it and place it at this point. So for that, click here on move. Then select this object. Then press enter. Then base point will be this end point. And I want to match this end point with this node point. So again shift right click. Click on node and click here on this point. So here it has been placed perfectly. Then I want to make this room as a private and this is a general room. So what I will do, I will remove this wall. To remove this wall, click here on press pull. Then click inside on this wall. Then take it on this side, specify thickness of 300. Enter. So that wall is removed. Then I want to connect these walls with this wall. So for that, again take your cursor on this wall, click and click here on this endpoint. Same way, again zoom here, click here on this wall. Once it becomes blue, you will have to click there. Click and click on this endpoint. So here these walls has been connected. Then press escape. Then I don't want this internal door, so I will just erase it. Type E, enter and use crossing window and remove this line also, enter. Then here also knob is there, that also we will remove. Type E, enter and select these knobs, enter. So in this way these two rooms are ready. But actually I want this portion on the front side. So what we will do, we will rotate it. So for rotate, click here on 3D rotate. Then select this object, enter. Then I want to rotate it as per blue circle. So zoom there, click here on blue circle. Then to make it opposite, angle will be 180 degrees. So type there 180, enter and escape. So here we have this design on the front side. Then in the previous tutorial, we have learned how to create these grills. So using that same method, you can create these grills also. So right now I will not create any grills. So I will remove this, type E, enter, select all this portion, enter. Again enter and remove this point also, enter. So these two rooms are ready. Then we will need one slab. So for slab creation, we will have to create one rectangle. Ensure that your UCS is word. Then click here on rectangle. Then click here on this endpoint and this endpoint. So here this rectangle is created. Then to give thickness to this rectangle, click here on extrude. Then select this rectangle, enter, take your cursor on this side and specify thickness of 150, enter. So here this slab is ready. Then we will move these two rooms and place it here. Click here on move, select these objects, enter, click here on this endpoint and on this endpoint. So here these two rooms has been placed perfectly. So that's all for now. In the next tutorial, we will learn to create these railings and this roof and these walls. Link to next tutorial will be given here. So please like, share and subscribe. Thanks for watching. We will again meet in next tutorial.